Are you a PhD scientist who wants a career in industry? Awesome. That is a great career option. I spent more than 20 years doing that myself, and I have loved it. Are you thinking perhaps you should do a postdoc first? If you want a career in industry, that's not such a good idea. So, what should you do instead? Keep watching. Hey everybody, Dave Giltner with Turning Science. So I recently posted a video giving my thoughts on doing a postdoc if you want a career in industry. Now this video has received a lot of attention, more than any other video I've posted, so it's very clear many of you out there are dealing with this question and thinking about it a lot. So I wanted to revisit the question and give you some additional thoughts. Now if you haven't seen that video, in short, my position is do not do a postdoc if you are planning a career in industry. If you haven't seen that video, I will post a link to it right up here. So I know the pressure to do a postdoc can be very strong. I've heard from a lot of people who say, boy, a lot of people here in my science department are telling me I really ought to do a postdoc. And that's not surprising. Your thesis advisor, your entire thesis committee probably all did postdocs. That's obviously part of the traditional path to become a professor. You may have postdocs in your research group, and it's likely that all of these people are strong advocates for doing a postdoc because that's how they launch their own careers. That's what they know. But your career path is not the same as theirs. And so these people are not, they're very well-meaning, but they are not the right people to give you advice about what the right step is for the next step in your career. They just aren't. Now, I've been out in industry for more than 20 years. I've worked a variety of different jobs at several different companies doing a lot of exciting things. And I can tell you, doing a postdoc is not your best next step. It just isn't. It's time you got out in the real world to see how it works. You spent enough time in academia. Get out, figure out how companies work, how the real world works. That is your next best step. But first, it will help for you to get beyond this pro-postdoc attitude you are likely surrounded by. This is a really important part of your job search, and that's what I want to talk about today. Look, working around other people who do not understand or appreciate the career path that you are taking can be a real challenge. It can make it really hard to maintain the positive attitude that you need to be successful. So the first thing you need to do is to develop a clear and strong position on why this is best for you. Now, you may not change anybody else's mind, and that's fine, although you might. But what you will do is you will solidify the position in your own head, and that is really important. Look, finding a job is challenging, and you need the right attitude in order to maintain the persistence you need to be successful. So I've learned there are two different ways you can behave when your opinion differs from the people around you, the people you live with or the people you work with. So the first option is you can just remain silent. You can know that you differ, and you can try and avoid a conflict. The second way is to present your position clearly and confidently and give people the opportunity to see it from your perspective. Give them the chance to see it your way. Now, I've learned this second way is so much better. Rather than being quiet, trying not to cause a stir, and subconsciously all the time eroding the confidence in your own head about your position, you stand up for what you believe. Don't have to convince people, but you at least say, well, this is why this is best for me. This is a much better position for looking for a job, and it's a much better position for maintaining a good working environment during the time you are still there in university. So how do you go about doing this? I have three steps. So first, define your target. Figure out what you want to do and where you want to do it. Now, this is an important part of any career planning, and if you subscribe to this channel, I know you've heard me talk about it before. But if you're going to convince people you don't need to do a postdoc, you better be able to say specifically what you do want to do. Now, it's great you know you want to work in industry, but that's a bit vague and it's hard to describe as a career path with any kind of conviction. You want to figure out something a bit more specific. For example, is there a technology that interests you? When I was finishing my PhD, I was really interested in lasers. I had worked with them in graduate school, and I was really interested in the potential that lasers had to do exciting things in the next decade. Perhaps there's a specific market or application that interests you. Maybe you're really interested in renewable energy, for example, and you're just very excited by the potential that new developments in renewable energy have for making our lives better. Or maybe it's something in medical applications. I've met a lot of early career scientists who are really excited by recent developments in biochemistry and the potential it has for medical applications that will help us all live healthier or longer lives. Whatever it is, decide specifically what it is that you want to do. This is an important first step because then it allows you to describe your plans with specificity and conviction. Second, get out and meet people who are working in your target area. Now, this will help you better understand what it's like to work in that area, which is great and important, but more importantly, it will help you build enthusiasm for following the path that you are planning. This is really important, particularly if you are in a group of people who are pressuring you to do a postdoc or think that's the best next step for you. You need to build a team of advocates who understand the path you are taking and understand why that is the right next step for you. So get out there and build that team of advocates. Now, you can meet these people a number of different ways. LinkedIn is a great resource. And by the way, if you don't have a LinkedIn profile, create one today. I really mean it. It's very important. You can find people on LinkedIn, or you can find other creative ways to go out and meet them, whether it's conferences, whether it's meetups, collections of people will get together who are working in your target area, or whether you find creative ways to set up informational interviews with people who are working in the technology or the market or the application area you are interested in. All of these are great ways, but it's a really important step. Third, tell your advisor or your supervisor or your PI or whatever you call them. But now that you've got your target defined and you've spoken with people who are your advocates who agree that you're taking the next best step for you and your career plans, then is your opportunity to start stating your position clearly and with conviction and give other people the opportunity to see it from your perspective. And again, you may not convince anybody, but you might. But more importantly, you will convince yourself. As you tell this story to other people, as you describe it with clarity, with conviction, with confidence, you will build more confidence in your own plan for yourself. And this is really important as you go out and start doing the challenging work of finding that first job outside academia. So you want to keep this conversation short and to the point. And if you're wondering where to start, I'll give you an outline right here. And if you want to take notes, or if you're taking notes, I'll actually put this outline in the description notes below this video, so you don't have to write down everything I'm saying. You can find it there. So I would start with something pretty straightforward and simple. I've decided I want a career in industry, and so I'm not going to be doing a postdoc. That would be a good first step in an introduction. Next, I would give them the reason that you want a career in industry. And I would start with something that is not emotional based, but more factual or rational based, something that will make sense to them. Something like, I want to go out and make things that people can actually use. Or it might be after a number of years in an academic environment here in graduate school, I've decided that I really don't want the career of a professor. Or it might be something more like, I've realized that there are so few academic positions out there that I don't want to spend years chasing it only to end up in an industry position anyway. That would be a very solid case to make. Third, talk about the emotional side of it. Talk about why you are excited about an industry career. And this is an important step because it shows it's not just something you read somewhere or maybe somebody convinced you that it's the right thing to do. You're telling them that your heart is really in it. What about it excites you? Finally, just briefly tell them why you aren't going to do a postdoc. Something along the lines of, given that I'm going to work in industry, a postdoc is just not the right step for me. I need to get out in the private sector and learn how it works right now. I've already been in academia longer than most people in the world, and I want to get out into industry and get started right now. So if you follow this outline, that should give you a really good, solid introduction. I'm sure the conversation will continue from there, but you will have made a strong, solid case up front, and from there, the conversation should be much easier. Now, I didn't have this advice when I was leaving graduate school. As you may know from some of my other videos, I was a physicist, PhD physicist. I worked in a laser spectroscopy lab, and so my target was the laser industry, specifically for scientific instruments. So as an example, here's how that conversation might have gone if I had had this example, this advice ahead of time when I was having that conversation with my advisor. Do you have a minute? I wanted to talk to you briefly about my career plans. So I know you've mentioned several times in the last few months, you've got a lot of great connections at universities around the country, and you could get me a postdoc as soon as I'm ready to graduate and move on from here. But I want to let you know, I'm planning a career in industry, and I do not plan to do a postdoc. After 6 years in graduate school, I've seen a lot about what the life and career of a professor is like, and I've honestly decided that's not best for me. What I want to do is to make things that people can use, just like all those instruments that are in our lab that we use on a regular basis. So, as you know, I've learned a lot about laser technology working in your lab, and it's been great. But what I'm really excited about is getting a job in the laser industry at one of these companies making the next generation of scientific instruments for researchers like you and me to use into the future. I've met a number of people who work at these companies, several different companies, and it sounds like really exciting work, and I'm really excited to get started. But doing a postdoc just really is not the best step, the best next step for me to take. I've been in academia a long time. I've gotten a lot of technical knowledge. What I need to do now is get out and learn how companies work, learn how industry works. So that's my plan. I'm really excited to get started, and I hope I have your understanding and your support. So that's an example of how I might have had this conversation with my advisor, had I had this advice back when I was preparing to leave graduate school, head out into an industry career, and not do a postdoc. Now, I realize this conversation with your advisor might be a real concern. It can be a sensitive topic. And so if you're worried about it, I suggest you practice a few times with somebody safer, somebody who can give you feedback on your pitch, perhaps ask some questions, and get you to a place where you're more confident with your message and how you state it before you have that much more critical conversation with your advisor. These could be fellow students, your lab partner. It might even be, you might even consider a couple of professors in your department, people who you can try this out on and see their reaction and respond to their questions before you talk to your advisor. Now, of course, you want to make sure these are safe people who aren't going to run and tell your advisor before you have the conversation. But that could be a real help and help you be more confident. In the end, you're going to want to talk to everybody about this because these are your career plans, and the whole point is to get comfortable with confidently stating, this is what I'm planning to do, this is why I'm excited about it, and here's what is next for me. And so you're going to talk to everybody. Talk to the people you work with, talk to people you meet at conferences, even tell your family. They can be a great place to get that practice and build that confidence that this is what I'm doing and this is why I'm excited about it. So once you've done these three things, you've defined your target, you've talked to people who have followed the same career path as you and agree that it is a good path, and you've learned to confidently and clearly describe the path you're pursuing and perhaps had that challenging conversation with your advisor, once you've done all those things, you still have to go out and find a job in your target area. And that's challenging. If you're worried about that, you're struggling with that, if you'd like some help with that, I have just the thing for you. I've just completed my Essential Industry Job Search Guide for Scientists, and I want to give it to you for free. If you look in the description notes below this video, you'll find a link that says Essential Job Search Guide. Click on that link, and it will take you to a page where you can get this great guide for free. Now, I'm sure you're well aware there's plenty of job search advice out there already. How is this guide different? Well, most of that information that's already out there has been put together by people who make their careers giving job search advice, not by people who have spent their careers actually working in industry, working in the companies where you want to go find a job. I have. I've been out there more than 20 years in a variety of industries, in a variety of companies, learning how companies work and what hiring managers actually want. And that's what I've put in this guide. I talk about what do hiring managers actually look for in a resume. I talk about how can you describe your academic research experience in a way that will be intriguing to an industry hiring manager, that will make them take notice and make you stand out. I even talk about how can you sound like you have some industry experience when you really don't. All of that is in this guide, and I want to give it to you for free. If you want to get this great guide, look in the description notes below the video. Look for Essential Job Search Guide and click on the link. It'll take you to a page where you can drop your email and get this great guide for free. So that's what I suggest you do instead of doing a postdoc. Thanks for watching, and I hope you found this video helpful. If you liked it, please click the like icon below. It'll help me, but more importantly, it will help other people who can benefit from this video because more likes means YouTube shows it to more people. I'd also really appreciate it if you would share it with your friends and your colleagues. And if you'd like to get more of these videos yourself, click that subscribe button and ring that notification bell. I post about two of these every month to help you design and build the career you really want. Thanks for watching. Now let's get out there and turn science into things people need.